High School. Although we're unable to hold a traditional graduation ceremony this year, we're very thankful that we are able to hold an event that will allow each of the members of the El Capitan graduating class of 2020 to come to campus one more time and walk across the stage here at their school. We also wanted to put something together on video to allow you to hear the speeches that would have been presented at an in-person ceremony. Let's begin with a pledge to our flag by the familiar voice of Martha Monzo, who led the campus in the pledge at 8 a.m. every morning of the school year. Following Martha will be El Capitan vocalist Cassette Asenjo singing the national anthem. Again, welcome.
Good evening, Gauchos. Please join me for the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Familiares y amigos. Entonces, bienvenidos a todos y gracias por su apoyo a lo largo de nuestro exitoso viaje académico.
Jong 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 Jong
It is my pleasure to announce the valedictorians and salutatorians for the El Capitan class of 2020. First, we have 38 valedictorians to honor this evening. Tariq Davalori, Samir Alkahori, Derek Ma, Madeline Zhang, Myra Lua Reyes, Wendy Park, Myra Velasquez, Simon Zhang, Genesis Urell, Aiden Mitchell, Angela Lomeli Flores, Pearson Bender, Lorena Ortiz Vasquez, Mary Dagney, Melissa Valenzuela, Karen Boggs, Christopher Coutone, Madeline Knudsen, Hannah Erd, Rachel Lebanon, Kylie Nicholson, Jesus Castaneda Ceja, Natalie Collins, Serena Malhai, Cosette Asino, Emily Montez Martinez, Marin Winnick, Stephanie Cienfuego Nunez, Tessa Gonzalez, Jolene Herb, Chase Miner, Alyssa Bauer, Enrique Estrada, Yadav Cruz, Aja Hassan Warren, Joshua Duet, Nyla Hassan Warren, and Isabella Segarra. Our salutatorian is Haley Mua. Congratulations to each of these scholars for graduating at the top of their class. We also want to congratulate the Gold Court winners. These students have earned a GPA of 3.5 or better. This year, we have 150 Gold Court recipients. This year's student speeches will be presented by Speaker at Large, Trevor Fife, and one of our valedictorians, Rachel Lebanon. So first we have Speaker at Large, Trevor Fife.
In my years before high school, I spent a lot of time wondering what the big takeaway from high school would be. What will be the lesson? What's the moral of the story? Then I finally got into high school, and I rolled my way through, and I laughed, and I cried, and I learned, I loved, I led, left a legacy, I did all that corny junk, and the whole time I continued to wonder, what is the takeaway? What is the lesson that I'm supposed to learn from all this? What is the moral of the story? Only in this last year did I realize that there is no one real lesson from high school. There are actually about a million of them. Some presented in much larger magnitudes than others. For example, I learned that not everything is a competition, but sometimes the lunch line can be. I learned that whoever tells you that C's get degrees is likely not the wisest of souls, but that advice could save a couple long, stressful nights. I learned that trying is a far more impressive achievement than success, but success also is something worth working for. I learned that friends are forever, something like that. I also learned how easy it is to drop some very valuable things off a two-story balcony when you don't pay the closest attention to the way you're walking. I learned that it is very easy to fall behind, but that there's also a billion chances to get back up, and that failure isn't final most of the time, and that's nice. I learned that really the reason that high school is so special is because there's a million lessons to learn from it, and not everybody learns all the same lessons in all the same ways. I think that the beauty of high school is that it is an experience that is so shared and so universal, and yet it is a story that is so incredibly unique and so personal to everybody. And it's hard to differentiate between the years, and from a surface level, it's hard to differentiate the class of 2020 from the class of 2019, or the class of 2018, or 17, or 16, or any other year behind that. Our largest differential is that we are the only graduating class of El Capitan, or any other year, or any other year sitting in the audience whose year ended at home during a global pandemic. And that makes me sad to think about, because that means that we as a class have lost our name. COVID-19 is what the class of 2020 will likely be remembered for, and that stinks, because there's so much more that we should be remembered for. I've spent 4 years with the people I'm speaking before. I've spent time in clubs and classrooms and social circles, and apologies to literally any other class, but they are the most unique and brilliant and beautiful people and students that I've ever met in my entire life. Right now, the class of 2020 is known for being the class to graduate during the pandemic. But in 5, 10, 20 years, this class will be known for so much more. Every person in this crowd, and even the ones who aren't, are beyond extraordinary. I've met people in this very class who will be award-winning journalists and world-leading technologists. I've personally talked to future doctors, nurses, business owners, entrepreneurs, billionaires, millionaires, hundredaires, writers, filmmakers, producers, actors, artists, musicians, Olympic gold medalists, NFL, WNBA, MLB professional players, pro wrestlers, fashion designers, media producers, graphic designers, college professors, senators, congressmen, politicians, presidents, coaches, teachers. People sitting here right now will literally be teachers to the children of the people sitting around them right now. And that is actually kind of weird to think about. This is an incredibly unique pool of ambitious and visionary young people who are the defining class of a new generation. These are the students who are going to change the world, and I truly believe that. That being said, as of right now, they were all sitting right here today, me among them. They all just got through high school, one day at a time, side by side, like every class that came before them. They're all a little bit worried about the future. They're all a little bit stressed, and we're all a little bit shook up from all that's been happening recently. But if anything, that in and of itself is the lesson. If there is a takeaway, a moral, or a lesson from high school, I think it's that we don't always have control, but we do always have choices. And we do always have chances. I think that life is scary and unpredictable and hard, and I think that it's always out of control. But I think that we always have tomorrow. We might not always know what tomorrow looks like, but we always have the chance to make our own better tomorrow. Things haven't been easy recently, and we all know that, but even still, we can't forget to take as many moments as possible to celebrate. This right here is the time to celebrate, to reflect on everything that won't matter in a year, and give yourselves and your loved ones a pat on the back. We can't afford to overlook academic achievements. We can't afford to ignore all of the hard work we've done. The hard work that your children have done. We can't afford to forget everything we've done for the last 4 years and every moment that made this moment worth it. We can't forget to take a breather and celebrate little things and big things, even when the world comes crumbling down. This is important. This is taking a moment to look at this graduating class and to tell them that they are brave and that they've done so well, and that we can't wait to see what they do next. This is when we tell them, good job, you made it, and I'm so proud. Get ready to do it again tomorrow. You guys are going to change the world. I am beyond honored to be a part of this class. Congratulations to the incredible generation-defining class of 2020.
Thank you, Trevor. And next, we have Rachel Levinall giving our valedictorian speech.
On a crisp morning of my junior year,
I walked into Ms. Spurlock's classroom with the clammiest of hands. Sitting down, my fingers shaking my pencil, I scanned the prompt, which read, "We tend not to choose the unknown," which might be a shock or a disappointment or simply a little difficult to cope with. And yet it is the unknown, with all its disappointments and excitements, that is the most enriching. Reading the instructions, I scribbled on my paper, wondering how on earth I was going to explain the quote, unknown, and how, in turn, I was going to do well on the AP exam in May. Since those 40 minutes, the unknown has taken over my life many times. During my junior year, I chose to give up something I had invested my whole identity into. Basketball. Basketball was the routine I had scheduled everything else around for the last 11 years of my life. In an attempt to cope, I explored other hobbies, which led me to instill a completely different vision for my future. What I've learned about the future is the instinctual need to fill it, but the unreliability of it. We are taught when we are young to plan out our futures. In eighth grade, we all get these little forms to choose a career pathway that determines most of our high school classes. When hearing this as a 14-year-old, it can be easy to feel doubtful about something that seems so permanent. So when things do not go according to plan, everything becomes shaky, and it can get hard to keep motivation. The class of 2020 has been hit with one of the largest disruptors in history, the pandemic of COVID-19. Beginning self-isolation on March 16th, I had no idea the coming months would challenge my idea of reality so vastly. When I was a freshman, I joined the school newspaper club on campus. From that point on, my passion for journalism only grew. In March, I decided to produce a podcast about how high school seniors in Merced County have navigated through quarantine. These people were honestly the reason I got out of bed every morning. Without them, I would have sobbed for days on end about the milestones I have been dreaming of since I was 5. Passions are what get me through uncertainty, and journalism got me through the coronavirus. But passions are something I have always noticed makes people thrive in life. You can tell the difference between a teacher who cares about what they are teaching and a substitute who's thrown onto the job 5 minutes before the bell rings. Now, it is safe to say the country and world will be healing from this pandemic in many ways. But the class of 2020 is resilient. The quote from my essay, as cheesy as it was true. There will be moments when you fear that you'll crumple into a pile of exhaustion or sadness or anger. But there will also be moments where you find yourself happy in unexpected places. So class of 2020, I hope you find your passions, and I hope you stick to them, because those will keep you balanced. Follow your dreams, Gauchos, and know that clammy hands are for uncertainty. But uncertainty is what we thrive on.
Senior class president will present the class gift to next year's associate student body president, Parker Knudsen.
On behalf of the graduating class of 2020, I am proud to offer a banner for our school's quad with our motto that will boldly remind future gauchos to learn, love, lead, and leave a legacy. On behalf of El Capitan High School, we accept this gift. Thank you and congratulations to the class of 2020.
El Capitan class of 2020, on behalf of the school staff, it has been our privilege to spend the last 4 years as part of your lives. The last few months of your public education have been disrupted, but I definitely hope that is not the thing at the forefront of your minds today. One of the secrets to being an overcomer and enjoying life is the ability to understand and perceive any moment or circumstance in time as it relates to the whole. Your education has spanned 12 years, and your efforts, accomplishments, and experiences of those years far overshadow the disruption of the last few months. You've spent 4 years at El Capitan, and my hope is all those great experiences far outweigh the recent challenges. I could talk about many things as important to success as you move forward with the next steps of your journey. Typically, we focus on being great at something, or excelling in a certain area in college, or having financial wisdom, and a host of other things. All of these are definitely important, but some of the real keys to success and happiness in your life are, in concept at least, a bit more simple and within reach of each one of you to accomplish. First thing I want to talk about is you need to always be thankful. No matter what goes on in your life from this point forward, and life will definitely have its ups and downs, you always have something to be thankful for, even on the worst of days and amidst the toughest experiences. When things seem bad or you have a disappointment and find yourself starting to feel a bit down, you need to stop and realize things could be much worse. There's always someone else in the world that is in a worse situation than you at that moment. That moment and that situation is not the end. Tomorrow will come and your feelings will brighten up again. One of the Proverbs tells us, "He that is of a merry heart has a continual feast." This means that even if there is very little on the table, the person who is of a thankful and cheerful spirit enjoys it as a feast. This pertains not only to food, but to every area of your life. Some of you are excited for your futures. Some of you are doubtful for your futures. And some of you are unhappy because the outlook is not what you wanted or hoped for. If you can just turn your attitude towards being thankful right now, whatever circumstances are in front of you, your whole perception of life will change. Monday is the best day of the week because we're thankful that we are blessed with another week of opportunities and experiences. The next thing I want to talk about that's vital for you is always put others first. As you embark on the next steps towards a journey into your future, it is so easy for people to become self-focused. And it's so easy for this to become a habit, the mode of your life, and the outlook for living. Our society and our world desperately need people who think about others as much as they do about their own well-being. Will you develop into the type of person who is concerned about the emotional well-being of others, the physical well-being of others? If there's one piece of pizza, are you the person who lets someone else have it, even though you really want it also? If there is an argument, do you think about what the other person is feeling? Or are you just concerned with winning and getting your own point across? Are you able to think of the views of others and consider why they see things differently than you do? And are you able to accept that and not be set in your way that your view is right just because it's your view? No matter what you do in this world, I don't think you can be a success if you are self-centered and not compassionate and linked together with every other human being. Finally, something that's vital is always have a humble dependence. It's important for you to understand that as much as you can do and as much effort as you can put in, you do not have all the power within yourself to make things come out exactly like you want them to. If you're a farmer, you must put in the effort to plow the ground, sow the seeds, and do all you can to bring a harvest. But you need the rain and the sun to come. You need to hope the wind doesn't blow hard at the wrong time, or a whole host of other things that are beyond your power. As we have experienced recently, life can change dramatically, drastically, in an instant due to a virus we cannot even see. It's your duty to work hard, to plan ahead, to do all you can do in the things you have put your hands to. But I encourage you to always carry within you that understanding and that humble attitude that you're always dependent on things that are beyond your control. As you plan your life and as you move forward into the tasks that are before you, always take each step knowing you do not hold all power within your own hands. If you have these as foundational points in your life, if they are who you are, you'll be happy and you'll be a success wherever the road takes you. On behalf of the whole staff at El Capitan, and I dare also to say on behalf of your parents, guardians, family members, and the whole community, we love you, class of 2020. Each of you is vitally important to this world. We thank you for being excellent representatives of your school and community, and from the depths of my heart, good luck. Superintendent Peterson and members of the Merced Union High School District Cabinet, President Lopez, and members of the Merced Union High School District Boards, these Gaucho scholars have completed all of the requirements for graduation established by the State of California and the Merced Union High School District Board of Trustees. It is my honor to present to you the El Capitan graduating class of 2020.
Welcome, Gaucho family. My name is Richard Lopez, and I am the president of the Merced Union High School Board of Trustees. It is my honor to accept the El Capitan High School graduating class of 2020. It is always a pleasure to be a part of this memorable ceremony and to hear about all of your wonderful accomplishments. I wish you the best, Gauchos, and congratulations.
Austin Garner. Ana Sheila Vasquez. Kaylee Oakley. Thank you. Jesus Torres. Quartalyn Iqbal. Anthony Balladad. Joseph Pia. Sharon Antner. Mi Vang. Harrison Satern. Dakota Van Zyl. Stephanie Cabezas. Christina Rayburn. Genesis Yale. Edward Stinson. Gustavo Gonzalez Alejo. Devin Noyes. Daniela Belmonte. Daniela has also graduated from Merced College. Emily Sue Micah Mua. Korea Love Jordan. Kaya Gutierrez. Marissa Ike. Andrew Pangelina. Sierra Alvarez. Javon Davis. Austin Wade. Arshika Garcha. Angelina Hernandez. Sarah Johnson. Jasmine Velez. Zamani Wilson. Alan Hernandez. Oh. Stephanie Arellano Anaya. Jose Hernandez. Araceli Venegas. Hannah Herr. Omar Delgado. Crisady Brito Roman. Litzy Chavez Vasquez. Lyric Adam. Aaron Lutweiler. Ita Hernandez. Madeline Jean. Rachel Livinall. Alexis Seychelles. Dylan Comfer. Yeah. Citlali Morales. Rigoberto Padilla. Tyler Paskin. Imogen Say Chow. Maximus Bulliard. Ángel Cortés. Joel Titleman. Alicia Ramos. Daniela Mezcua. Oscar León. Lauren Mariscal. Infant. Alizel Joyce Marcos. Sahil Singh. Yeah. Jaspreet Singh. Jasmine Vasquez. Enrique Estrada. Alex Benitez. José Martinez. Scott Kovalchek. Yatsari Lua. Kamar Bashore. Martha Manzo. Abigail Tovez. Jesús Castañeda Ceja. Ali Garcia. Jonathan Leon Rios. Naomi Parra. Zaira Gonzalez Loriano. Jose David Gonzalez Aguilera. Jose Higuera. Dulce Morfin. Jocelyn Hill. Alondra Diego Gutiérrez. José Esquivel. Genesis Olivares. Jaime Álvarez. Jonathan Alvarez. Emily Enriquez. José Hernández. Josué Argüelles. ¡Woo! Jimena Romero. Yoki Vang. Ariana Day. Nancy Vang. Rodriguez. Jasmine Nunez. Jonathan Cervantes. Kiera Daniels.
It's too late now.
Darius Belly. Giovanna Martinez.
Yeah.
Elijah Gilliam. Yadira Chavez!
Good job, Eric!
Albertano Trinidad de Jesús!
Yeah.
Rolando Guillen.
Adrian Hurtado. Jefferson Yang.
Daniela N. Perez.
We're good. Lizette Enriquez. Isabella Segura. Gal Mi Vang.
Okay, I know. That's right. Yeah. Really hard.
Brody Ferguson. Danielle Passos.
Thank you.
Pia Tao. Romel Lacia Chavez. Melissa Vidueta. Zachary Posse Jr. New Chang. Calista Curran.
Getting it consistent. That's no excellent. We're actually, we bought a few of our own stuff.
Mary Daxi. Diego Hernandez. Aja Hassan. Yadid Cruz. Abigail Romero. Tarek Devaleri. Thank you.
Vanessa Morales Ortega. Jose Asenjo. Marin Winnick! Kylie Nicholson! Alyssa Nicole Bauer. Yelena Melissa Valenzuela! Clarissa Regina Tapatio! Brianna Lagunas! Natalie Santayano! Thank you. Melanie Limas Regalado. Miguel Manzo Lopez. Myra. Myra Cristal Lua Reyes. Marla Carpenter. Sophia Alexis Aguilar. Ariana. Alexis Brummel. Elena Urrutia. Lorelai Zhang. Genevieve Deanda Hernandez. Thank you. Jordan Williams. Silva.
Stephanie Rosales. Jose Quesada. Pedro Angel Vega. Anastasia Ortiz Aguayo. Didier Lawrence. Gilberto Gutierrez. Angel Escobar. Fernando Jose Duran. Christian Basave. Miguel Pacheco Lopez. Bridget Patricio. Armando Trinidad. Austin Bichai Chong. Steven Rice. Yolanda Barrientos. Capitan! Jesus Enrique Castaneda. Espinoza Hartwell. Christine Koenig. Elena Lopez. Dylan Greenwood, number 5.
Congratulations to the class of 2020. Good luck in the future. Wake up every Monday looking forward to the opportunities of another amazing week. Be confident, be happy, love others, and go Gauchos!